From the same idiot who told you to get the Pichu Lab Wisp as the last one in Unova, here comes somewhat of a sequel guide. How to invest in the Halloween event, which was supposed to be ready earlier, but life got in the way. We'll be looking at how you can invest the money you gain from smuggling thousands of Pokemon to sketchy toddlers, beating noobs in PvP, taking candies from kids, and fighting weird floating pumpkins, so you can become rich and retire from doing painful gym runs in this stupid game we all love. And if you enjoyed this bad comedic take, like the video. And if you didn't, dislike it, so I can understand how bad my humor actually is. Comedic break is over. Now, let's get serious. For those of you who want the quick tip, pumpkin goodie bags are weird this year, I honestly don't know. Mysterious Dusk Ball come as the safe bet, 115% ROI could be expected. And goodie bags could be the dark horse of the event, the contrarian play for intelligent small investors. Disclaimer, I won't be investing in the Halloween event, not because I don't believe in what I'm about to show you, but because I flip a lot and I get better returns by using the money to buy and sell Pokemon in this game. That said, we'll be looking at the main investing items with historical data to try to predict something, so no PvP mystery boxes. I need to be honest with you right away, I don't know if these are a good investment this year, and before we go further, I know a lot of you are thinking, the prices crashed because of the Halloween update, everyone panicked and sold. Here's the thing, their prices didn't move when the update dropped. They were already at 17.9k before the panic even started, and you might already know that. So if it wasn't the update that collapsed the prices, what was it? That's what we need to figure out. These floor prices are 53% lower than last year, so the question is this a buying opportunity, or is the market telling us something we're missing? Let me walk you through what I found. First, let's check the obvious. Were they massively overfarmed? From 2023 to 2024, supply increased almost 4 times, but from 2024 to 2025, only 36% more. So yeah, there was more supply than last year, but not enough to explain a over 50% price drop on its own. Something else is going on. And we already know it wasn't panic from the update. Prices had already collapsed before that happened. So what changed? Let me show you what I think is really behind it all. This year the entire Halloween reward structure changed in ways it never has before. Every year there was one ultra rare vanity from Pumpking Goodie Bags. That was the chase item everyone wanted. But look at 2025. We have 4 ultra rares across the event. Now here's where it gets interesting for Pumpkin Goodie Bag specifically. Because of aesthetics, most people want the mermaid hair. That's the chase item. Last year, you were guaranteed to get the valuable ultra rare when you pulled one from the Pumpkin Goodie Bags. This year, your odds of getting the mermaid hair are now 1 in 3. But here's the real kicker, the green slime is also obtainable from regular goodie bags, which historically cost 3 to 6 times less than pumpkin goodie bags. So now you can potentially get one of the 3 pumpkin ultra rares from a much cheaper source. But wait, there's more! There's now a PvP mystery box with its own exclusive ultra rare, diverting spending into a completely different reward path. The entire Halloween economy got diluted across 4 ultra rares and multiple item types instead of one clear chase item from one source. And I think that's why Pumpkin Goodie Bags prices collapsed over 50%. Not the update, not just oversupply, but fundamentally worse odds combined with cheaper alternatives and competing reward paths. Now, even in good years, these weren't amazing investments. So we're talking slow, modest returns, even when the structure was better. This year, with everything that changed, I honestly don't know. Some whales have been buying at these prices, you can see buyouts happening in the market cap data, so someone thinks there's value here, but I'm not convinced yet. Maybe this 50% discount is enough to overcome the structural problems and you get 30 to 50% returns over the next year. Or maybe the market's correctly pricing in that these are fundamentally less valuable now and they will stay down. I don't have enough data to know which one it is. So here's where I land on Pumpkin Goodie Bags. Floor price 53% lower than 2024. Supply 36% higher than 2024. Price has already collapsed before the update. First time with 3 URs from Pumpking Goodie Bags. 1 UR also available from a cheaper regular goodie bag. New PvP mystery box competing for attention. And historical returns only 19 to 20% in 1 year. And here's what we don't know. If the structural changes permanently lower value, if this discount compensates for worse odds, if the prices will recover or not. In all honesty, this is a bet, not an investment. The data is messy. The changes this year are unprecedented. If you want to speculate on a potential recovery, buy a small position and target 22 to 24k for 20 to 35% upside, matching or slightly beating historical performance if this discount is real. That's at best a reasonable low-risk bet with modest potential. But if you're asking me, should I invest in this? My answer is only if you're comfortable with genuine uncertainty and okay with potentially tying up money for a year for returns that might not happen. There seems to be better plays in this event, and what I'm about to show you next is the opposite of uncertain. So, I always like to keep myself accountable. This was the old prediction I made in my first investment video. First, comparing to last year's floor prices, useless now. Alpha Fossils changed everything. Second, I said I thought they would peak during Shiny Wars, but I needed to analyze it further in another video. Well, this is that video, and the data showed me I was wrong. This is Mysterious Dusk Balls 2024. Watch what happens. Prices rise, 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 then July hits, and look at this supply explosion. Everyone dumps at once when Shiny Wars starts. So prices don't peak during Shiny Wars, they crash during Shiny Wars. The peak actually happens months earlier, in May and June, when prices stabilize and smart investors start quietly exiting. Let me prove this isn't just one example. I'll show you Mysterious Ultra Balls from 2024. Same pattern, and before I say that's just two examples, let me show you this plays out everywhere, sometimes more or less noticeably. These are Mysterious Pokeballs from 2024, these are Mysterious Great Balls from 2024, and these are Mysterious Cherish Balls from 2025. This isn't a coincidence, this is predictable behavior, and this predictability, that's the edge you're getting by watching my videos. So make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. You didn't see that one coming, did you? Now, coming back to Mysterious Dusk Balls 2024 to show you this best. Two critical dates. Date number 1, Shiny Wars announcement. Prices are still high here. And date number 2, Shiny Wars starts. This is when everyone panic sells. You can start selling slowly as early as May and more aggressively after the announcement. But you need to be completely out before everyone and their mom dumps their positions. So to correct my initial hypothesis, this should be considered a short-term investment rather than long-term. Their optimal window is about 6 months. Now let's make this concrete with real numbers. Let's say you bought 10 million in Mysterious Balls at floor price during Halloween 2024. You sell in May or June at the stable price, but I'll use the Shiny Wars announcement date for pricing to be conservative. And if I did the same calculations with all the other balls, here's what each one would look like. Just to make this as complete as possible for you, I'll show you the average from this strategy from 2024 and from 2023. Here's the same analysis for the first set of Mysterious Balls for the Shiny Wars of 2023. As you already know, this first set investment was wild, and I don't think it's fair to compare anything to it. That's why we're using 2024 as the benchmark. Let's compare now to the 1 year ROI I told you in my last video. Well, that's not bad for a follow-up analysis, right? Now, another thing to consider is the supply we saw during this year's event. PokeMMO Hub doesn't have the supply for all days, but here's the supply peak during the 2024 Halloween event comparing to the same date, November 10th of this year. Now, this could mean they were 4 times more farmed this year, or it could mean that whales bought 4 times more in the last one. Let me show you how these hidden whales have been investing in the event. This is the daily market cap from November 4 to November 12. they have been slowly buying the balls in a smart way to not drive prices up. And you might be thinking, well, that's normal and doesn't change anything. Well, my friend, here's the price graph from Mysterious Pokeball 2024. Looks normal, right? Well, these aren't normal, these are the whales. One player, thousands of balls, all sold at once. And you need to understand you are not just competing with small investors. You're playing a game where whales can crash the market in under 24 hours. So you need to be smart when to sell. I know this is a lot of information, so let's recap to make it easier to absorb. Here's your playbook. If you bought them at 43k, which was the floor price, you should target 90k as an exit point. It could happen in May or June in 2026. Your expected ROI could be 115% in 6 months, but watch out for the supply being almost 4 times higher than 2024, whales can dump anytime, and Shiny Wars dates could shift. Your move depends on your risk tolerance, but now you can make an informed decision. And now, the last one. I saved this one for last to reward you for sticking with me this far. Because this one, this could be the best opportunity of the event, especially for small investors, and you'll see why. Let's get into it. These are the floor prices, and you might be wondering, wait, they're double last year's floor price. That should be a red flag, right? Higher floor prices equals worse investment. Not necessarily. Here's what changed this year. For the first time ever, goodie bags can drop an ultra rare vanity, the green slime. So now goodie bags aren't just cheap sealed products. They're a discount version of the pumpkin goodie bags. You get a chance at an ultra rare, but at a fraction of the cost. But here's where it gets really interesting. This year, goodie bags were farmed half as much as last year. Why? Because farming them wasn't profitable, but now they have ultra rare potential. Let me show you just how ignored this became. Every year, goodie bags get more and more overlooked relative to pumpkin goodie bags. People are sleeping on this harder than ever, right when they become more valuable than ever. Now let's look at historical performance. So this is their return in 1 year, way better than the pumpkin goodie bags. And remember from my last video, cheap loot boxes historically outperformed the expensive ones. So goodie bags have a track record of solid returns, and that was before they could drop ultra rares. These are their historical peak prices, and here's the bet. What if this year's goodie bags, with ultra-rare potential, behave more like cheap pumpkin goodie bags rather than old goodie bags? And they don't need to reach full pumpkin prices to be good. Now here's the peak prices for pumpkin goodie bags from 2023 and 2024. Let's put that into perspective with what we have covered today. Mysterious balls can get you 115% ROI in 6 months, but it's declining and there's 4 times more supply. Goodie bags can have the potential to give you 100-150% ROI in 1 year if the UR drop potential gets priced in. Similar returns, but goodie bags have way less supply and a structural change that might not be fully priced in yet. Now, is this guaranteed? Absolutely not. But look at this, even though the market cap isn't big enough to attract whales, you can see the buyouts in the market cap data. These buyers see the same opportunity I do. Under farmed supply, new UR drop potential, plus historical strong performance. It's a smaller pond, but this could become a very niche item. So here's my playbook for goodie bags. Floor price at around 8 to 10k, half the cost of the pumpkin goodie bags. They can now drop ultra rares for the first time ever. The supply is cut in half versus last year. Their historical performance is very strong, 71 to 95% ROI even without the UR drops. Most underfarmed relative to pumpkin in recent event history. And some accumulation visible, not major whales, but serious investors. And the risks? Unproven, we don't know how UR drops affect pricing. There's lower liquidity than mysterious balls. You must be patient to do it. It could just follow old goodie bag patterns instead of pumpkin patterns, and it only drops one of the three URs. It isn't the less valuable one though. So here's the bet. If you believe the market hasn't priced in the UR potential drop and you believe the 50% supply cut matters, then Goodie Bags at 8 to 10k might be the best risk-adjusted play in the event for you. And here's my take. This is for contrarian investors who see structural changes before the market does. Mysterious balls are the safe, proven play with clear historical patterns. Goodie bags are the what if the market is wrong play. I think there's real value here. The supply cut is dramatic, the UR drop is unprecedented. Even though the market cap isn't big enough for major whales, you can see buyouts from investors who see the value. But you need to be comfortable holding for a full year and accepting that this thesis might not play out. Your move, as always, depends on your risk tolerance. But if you made it this far in the video, you're exactly the type of investor who might see what these other investors are seeing. If you enjoyed this video, you'll probably also like this one, or you can binge watch my whole Halloween playlist. I don't care, but the GTL does. See you in the next one.